Hello, and welcome to your virtual field trip. My name is Deb, and I'm a teacher on special assignment at School Mental Health Ontario. We've partnered with our friends at OFIA to offer these virtual field trip videos on stress management and coping. We've learned about breathing, stretching, and visualization. Today, we are learning about distraction as a possible strategy to help us cope with stress. It seems like the perfect time to come to one of my favorite spots. When I feel stressed, I like to get outside and move my body. It's a welcome break from the screen, and it feels good to get moving. Plus, there's so many beautiful things to see and to hear. In this video, I'm excited to get some help from a few friends. They're going to share why you might use distraction and encourage you to try using this strategy. Or, if you already use it, you might be inspired to try a new activity. Remember, each of us is unique, and strategies that work for some might not work for others, and that's okay. Let's get started.
Hello, my name is Tracy Groves, and I'm a social worker with School Mental Health Ontario. A social worker is someone who helps you with your worries and your problems. From time to time, all of us feel overwhelmed with feelings and situations that cause stress. Distraction is one strategy that we can use to give us some space between those feelings and an opportunity to settle our mind and emotions. There are many activities that can help refocus your mind, and each of us is different in what works best for us. Some of us like to do art and coloring. Some may like to listen to music, while others might prefer something more physical, like riding a bike or a sport. Each of us have our own spiritual and cultural activities, family practices or rituals that have meaning to us. We want to encourage you to think of those activities that distract you from your worry or stress. Choosing something that brings you joy and brings positive feelings gets you out of your head and is a way for you to feel better. While distraction doesn't make a situation go away, when we just have some space from what's causing us to feel overwhelmed or distressed, we may often approach it with a clearer mind when we have fresh eyes on it. In fact, I'm going to listen to some music right now. And maybe I'll even do a little dancing, because I do enjoy dancing.
We asked Ontario students what they did to distract themselves when they were experiencing stress. Here's what students in grades 4, 5, and 6 had to say.
I listen to music because music calms me.
I jump on the trampoline or go for a walk because it is fun and gets my mind off something else.
I go and see my horse or ride him because my horse can feel what I feel.
I distract my brain from feeling worried, nervous, or stressed by writing my feelings down. When I put them on a page, then I don't think about them as much.
Many junior students named biking as a way they distract themselves.
I ride my bike as fast as I can.
I go on a bike ride with my friends.
Hi, my name is Andrea. I am an educator. I am also an OFIA ambassador. Today, I will be sharing with you some activities that I enjoy doing alone, with my family, and with my friends. These activities are a great way to distract me when I find it hard to concentrate or stay focused. They even help me when I'm feeling stressed. I find that after these activities, I'm more focused and also ready to learn.
Here are some examples of activities you can try doing alone or with someone at home. You can do these activities inside or outside any time of the year. These are a great way to take your thoughts away from uncomfortable feelings and to do the things you enjoy. Making time to do what you enjoy is a great distraction tool to manage your stress. While I do activities such as these, I feel tension releasing from my muscles and can even notice my breathing slowing down. Afterwards, I notice that I feel more calm, happy, and ready to learn.
What distractions do you use? When do you choose to use distractions? Have you noticed if your feelings change as you are doing the activity or how you feel after?
Educators, please refer to the virtual field trip lesson plan for activities to help consolidate this learning. We also encourage you to revisit the Student Mental Health Action Kit for further supports and resources. Thank you for joining OFIA and School Mental Health Ontario on this virtual field trip. We hope you find these strategies helpful. Educators, don't forget to stay connected by following OFIA on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram at OFIA Canada. Also, follow School Mental Health Ontario at SMHO_SMSO on Twitter and follow our youth account on Instagram at ThriveSMH.